Next, enticing students, especially girls, to stay in school by promoting a future for them in science, technology, or engineering. NewsHour correspondent Spencer Michels has the story. It's part of our American Graduate Series, an 18-month project with other public media partners to examine the causes of and solutions to the high school dropout problem.
So this was a weapon to attack, usually at a castle.
In an after-school class at Frick Middle School in Oakland, California, 20 girls are trying to figure out how to build a catapult out of tongue depressors and rubber bands.
Okay, so you need to maybe figure out how to stop it there.
Ooh!
Among them is 13-year-old Ebony Green, an eighth grader who decided to sign up for this extra science class to improve her academic record and her chances of finishing school and going to college.
Ready again?
Ebony is one of 600 middle school and high school girls in Oakland and nearby cities enrolled in a program called Techbridge, which tries to inspire them to enter fields traditionally dominated by white or Asian males. At the same time, it keeps kids at risk of dropping out interested in school. Techbridge lets girls engineer and build things on their own with a little help.
Whoa! There you go.
It's interesting. I never knew about soldering, or I never knew about crystals or anything like that. And since I'm interested in that, I wanted to get into a program where it's a lot about it.
In addition to Techbridge, she's also taking part in school activities like cheerleading, which also meets after school. It's dark when she finishes practice and walks the six blocks home from school through a neighborhood where police sirens are commonplace.
The hard part is probably living in a net bad neighborhood. I know people that go here and they like get in a lot of trouble and it's loud sometimes. And police like comes over here sometimes for like next door neighbors and stuff like that, loud music and stuff like that, disturbances.
She comes from a single parent family. Her mother, Ina Hubbard, finds work occasionally as a home care worker and has two other children.
I've lived in worse neighborhoods growing up, you know, so it's not really bad. But she doesn't go outside much, you know, hang out with the neighborhood kids or anything.
Ebony does pretty well at school, not great. At home, she has a computer but no internet connection. She says it costs too much. She's frequently late for class, often an indication of problems.
When I get up in the morning, I don't get up like really early, so I have a lot of time, so I have to rush. And then when I get to school, I get there late.
Just go through the checklist.
Kevin Eastman, like many teachers in the Oakland schools, routinely deals with children having trouble.
Rodolfo, need a pass.
Eastman teaches regular science classes at Frick. Once a week, after school, Eastman spends 2 hours at Techbridge, which pays him using grant money to hook kids on learning.
I think science is probably one of the easiest things to get them interested in. I know I've taught a lot of math, and kids are really frustrated and struggling in math because of lack of skills.
I get confused very easily when I'm doing math.
So science is a place where we can do some things that are fun, intriguing, challenging.
Techbridge is enthusiastically endorsed by Oakland school officials, and Oakland can use the help. It's a city with startling contrasts of wealth, boasting charming hillside neighborhoods with bay views and good schools. Still, 45% of Oakland children don't attend Oakland public schools. The city also contains large pockets of poverty, mostly in the flatlands where Ebony's family lives. Taken together, the city's public schools have an alarmingly high dropout rate. Only about half those enrolled graduate from high school, according to Tony Smith, school superintendent for the last 2 years.
I think we haven't designed schools and the education system in ways that really meet the needs of all young people, and in particular, children of color, African American, Latino. Kids are being pushed out faster than anybody else, and that plays out then in terms of who's employed and who isn't. Plays out in terms of the crime, in terms of the extraordinary murder rate and violence in Oakland.
Recent State Department of Education figures show that 3% of eighth grade students in Oakland drop out before starting high school. For the superintendent, a major problem is that the students themselves and some educators don't expect much of the kids.
When you have patterns in the system of particular groups of kids not taking either advanced placement courses or staying in school or coming in so far below grade level, that people start to expect less and less.
Those are issues educators and nonprofit groups have been trying to figure out for decades. Techbridge, one of those groups, was founded in Oakland by Linda Kakelis, who puts a lot of stock in positive role models.
A lot of the girls that we work with never think about becoming an engineer or being a computer programmer. For girls from more disadvantaged areas and under-resourced schools, they do have less access to role models. They haven't met an engineer. They haven't met somebody in computer programming who could say what great jobs there are in these fields.
Techbridge attacks that problem head on by taking its girls on field trips to high-tech companies like Google, companies that are crying out for technically trained workers and not finding enough.
Has anybody done any kind of programming at all before? Has anybody used Scratch before?
It's a chance to see women at work in science and technology.
How many of you have ever clicked on "I'm feeling lucky"?
In short classes, this one is the sophisticated use of search they learn from Google employees.
This is a chance for me to reach out to these girls and show them something that's possible for them, a route that could be theirs.
At lunch in the big Google cafeteria, they sit next to women software engineers and programmers, some only a few years older than the girls.
We do competitions in math.
Yeah? What kind?
One of Techbridge's goals is to convince the girls that hard work actually pays off.
And I think part of the message that Techbridge wants to communicate is that science and engineering are fun and really cool, but that it also involves working hard and that working hard really can help you in your future. And we'll talk about a really hard math class that they took, how they found a tutor, studied harder, talked with teachers after school to get support.
EBONY Green is getting tutored in math.
EBONY is a real hard worker, so I think that she's going to make it because she tries hard.
A lot of kids, they'll be like that they're going to do good, but they usually just don't. They just say they will. But when I say it, I like actually try. And sometimes I fail, sometimes I fail, but I just try again. I'm not like other kids. I want to be like a lot of things, but I know that I'm gonna have to choose a couple. And there are vet, an actress, a home designer, a fashion designer, and a pediatrician.
Those goals are not impossible, say independent evaluators, who rate Techbridge high in changing attitudes, knowledge, and career aspirations of its girls. At the Stanford School of Education, the dean, Claude Steele, says that girls can succeed in technology.
I think you definitely can get them interested in tech. Even kids who don't have the best academic skills, when they get their hands on something, they realize they can understand it, and understanding it excites them.
I think it's going to lead me to go like to a scientific college. When I get to high school, I might still be interested in science, and I might be doing like really good in it. And I can probably get a couple scholarships.
EBONY, working often on her own, has figured out how to build complicated things with her own hands. And that's a source of pride and encouragement. In the last 11 years, 3,000 girls have taken part in Techbridge. For EBONY, the program may be the nudge she needs to stay in school.
Spencer's story is part of our American Graduate Series, a public media initiative funded by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting. On our website, we have extended interviews Spencer did with Oakland Superintendent Tony Smith and Claude Steele, the Dean of Stanford's School of Education.